Hey guys, this is David Kwan. President Obama did a speech today, and I just wanted to kind of react to an excerpt from that speech. And this part of the speech is where Obama talks about the use of drones. And he finally really just does a formal addressing of this issue. So I thought that was interesting. So I'm going to be watching it along here and kind of react to it. On certain parts, I will pause the video that I'm watching. And for copyright purposes, I suppose, I will just play it in the background so you'll hear Obama's voice. I'll be reacting to it. I'll pause to make some comments here and there. This is kind of like just gut reaction, so I'm just speaking as I see it. So I'm probably not going to be as, you know, whatever I say is whatever I say. And this video is not going to be edited, so whatever ends up happening is whatever ends up happening. Let's do this. All right, so let's begin the speech. Obama is going to talk in the background.
So it is in this context that the United States has taken lethal, targeted action against Al-Qaeda and its associated forces, including with remotely piloted aircraft commonly referred to as drones.
Okay.
Simple fact there. As was true in previous armed conflicts, this new technology raises profound questions.
Yes, it does.
About who is targeted and why.
Mm-hmm.
About civilian casualties and the risk of creating new enemies. About the legality of such strikes under U.S. and international law.
Great. Thank you for addressing those basic things.
About accountability.
Yep.
And morality.
So
let me address these questions.
Okay, cool. Thank you. Let's address those.
To begin with, our actions are effective.
Really? Are they really?
Don't
and
take
in what
my
matter?
Word for it.
Okay, I won't take your
in
word
the
for
intelligence
it.
Gathered at Bin Laden's compound, we found that he wrote, "We could lose the reserves to enemy's airstrikes. We cannot fight airstrikes with explosives."
Huh. Okay. So it's effective because Bin Laden's diary says that airstrikes are really hard to fight against. Sure. That's one way to look at it. It you know what? Is it effective or is it not effective? This is not a yes or no question in regards to drone strikes. In some cases, it would, and it depends on what measure you're measuring. What are you looking for? What results are you wanting? It will be effective in, I guess, shutting down some groups of Al-Qaeda network, but there's a lot of problems that go along with it that really the cost of this effectiveness, you really have to weigh against the cost of all the other things that drone strikes pose, all the other issues. Yeah, but drone strikes make terrorists more afraid of drones. There's no really, I wouldn't argue against that, sure.
Other communications from Al-Qaeda operatives confirm this as well.
Okay.
Dozens of highly skilled Al-Qaeda commanders, trainers, bomb makers, and operatives have been taken off the battlefield. Plots.
At what cost? It's the question, at what cost?
Have been disrupted that would have targeted international aviation, U.S. transit systems, European cities, and our troops in Afghanistan.
That's after the fact, and that's with hindsight. I'm pretty sure a lot of drone strikes, you need to argue that every, you know, has drone strike really prevented all those terrorist attacks that could be prevented? I guess some of those things there's evidence for that, but it's, I don't know, let's continue. It is a problematic approach, this, but President Obama is addressing this here.
Simply put, these strikes have saved lives.
That's debatable there. Whoa, that's a bold claim.
Moreover, America's actions are legal.
Currently, kind of.
We were attacked on 9/11. Within a week, Congress overwhelmingly authorized the use of force.
Wow, I can't believe Obama is justifying
under domestic law
the aftermath of 9/11.
The United States is at war with Al-Qaeda, the Taliban, and their associated forces.
Sure.
We are at,
I guess,
war with an organization that right now would kill as many Americans as they could if we did not stop them first.
Yeah, we're at war with organizations that we don't necessarily
care. This is
can't.
A just war.
This is
a
just
war waged proportionally, in last resort, and in self-defense.
Who wrote this speech? What?
And yet, as our fight enters a new phase, America's legitimate claim of self-defense cannot be the end of the discussion.
That's why you're going to extend it by bombing the hell out of people's drones. Okay.
Or even effective, is not to say it is wise or moral in every instance.
Glad you recognize that, Obama.
The same progress that gives us the technology to strike half a world away also demands the discipline to constrain that power or risk abusing it.
But constraints are done by the administration that is using it.
That's why, over the last 4 years, my administration has worked vigorously to establish a framework that governs our use of force against terrorists.
To cover your ass, pretty much.
Insisting upon clear guidelines, oversight, and accountability that is now codified in presidential policy guidance that I signed yesterday.
Yesterday? It took that long? This is very recent.
In the Afghan War Theater, we must and will continue to support our troops until the transition is complete at the end of 2014. And that means we will continue to take strikes against high-value al-Qaeda targets, but also against forces that are massing to support attacks on coalition forces. But by the end of 2014, we will no longer have the same need for force protection. And the progress we've made against core al-Qaeda will reduce the need for unmanned strikes. Beyond the Afghan theater, we only target al-Qaeda and its associated forces. And even then, the use
that's
of
the intention
is heavily constrained.
That's your claim.
America does not take strikes when we have the ability to capture individual terrorists. Our preference is always to detain, interrogate, and prosecute them.
Good to know. Good to know that is the preference. But really, when the constraint is existing, when the constraint is put in force and enforced by the same administration that is placed those constraints, there's no third party, you know, enforcing those constraints. That's a problem, because you still have the authority to ignore those constraints and no one will call you out for it.
America cannot take strikes wherever we choose. Our actions are bound by consultations with partners and respect for state sovereignty. America does not take strikes to punish individuals. We act against terrorists who pose a continuing and imminent threat to the American people.
That's probably the only right thing that you said in the speech.
Other governments capable of effectively addressing the threat. And before any strike is taken, there must be near certainty that no civilians will be killed or injured. The highest standard we can set.
That high standard simply hasn't worked out so far, has it?
Now, this last point is critical because much of the criticism about drone strikes, both here at home and abroad, understandably centers on reports of civilian casualties.
Among many other things, yes, that's probably the most important.
There's a wide gap between U.S. assessments of such casualties and non-governmental reports. Nevertheless, it is a hard fact that U.S. strikes have resulted in civilian casualties.
Thank you for the acknowledgement.
A risk that exists in every war.
Yes, sure.
For the families of those civilians, no words or legal construct can justify their loss.
And here you are, trying to justify it.
Those deaths will haunt us as long as we live. Just as we are haunted by the civilian casualties that have occurred throughout conventional fighting in Afghanistan and Iraq.
I would argue that's kind of different. Civilian that occur from conventional fighting as opposed to civilian that occur due to the use of drones. It's different because it is much more, well, it is much, I don't know, it's a complicated issue, but it's not right to equate the two as being very similar things. Because they're not.
But as Commander-in-Chief, I must weigh these heartbreaking tragedies against the alternatives.
I know, you have a tough job there, Mr. President. You have a tough job.
To do nothing in the face of terrorist networks.
That's not the alternative. What? The that is a false dichotomy to say I have the option of using drones to strike these facilities and to be effective against this war on terror. The alternative is to do nothing? What?
Invite far more civilian casualties. Not just in our cities, at home, and our facilities abroad, but also in the very places, like Sana'a, and Kabul, and Mogadishu, where terrorists seek a foothold. Remember that the terrorists we are after target civilians, and the death
yes.
toll from their acts of terrorism against Muslims dwarfs any estimate of civilian casualties from drone strikes.
That is no justification for the United States government itself to do the same thing as terrorists by accidentally killing civilians. That is not a justification.
So doing nothing's not an option.
Who wrote this speech?
Where foreign governments cannot or will not effectively stop terrorism in their territory, the primary alternative to targeted lethal action
yes.
would be the use of conventional military options.
Yeah, sure. Yeah, that's another alternative.
As I've already said, even small special operations carry enormous risks.
They do. I don't disagree with that.
Conventional air power or missiles are far less precise than drones.
That's
likely to cause
definitely
more
true.
Civilian casualties and more local outrage.
But again, that's just one option. One other option.
Lead us to be viewed as occupying armies. Unleash a torrent of unintended consequences are difficult to contain. Result in large numbers of civilian casualties and ultimately empower those who thrive on violent conflict. So it is false to assert that putting boots on the ground is less likely to result in civilian deaths or less likely to create enemies in the Muslim world.
That's true, but that's
not
the argument.
More U.S. deaths, more Black Hawks down, more confrontations with local populations, and an inevitable mission creep in support of such raids that could easily escalate into new wars.
Yeah, but at the same time, it is a matter of principle. So that's the video right there, and those were kind of my gut reactions throughout as it was playing. As you could have pretty much guessed by now, it was not a speech I enjoyed watching through. To me, that is by far one of the worst speeches I've ever seen Obama do. Who wrote that speech is beyond me. But then Obama is faced with the topic of the use of drones, and that's a pretty tough topic for him to sound good on, simply because of what is being done with the use of drones. But the principal aspect of it is really important. To me, what makes this kind of use of drones so problematic is not just about the cost effectiveness. You know, yeah, it might cost more lives. It's very risky to do kind of conventional special ops or black ops or whatever. But simply putting a drone up there and ordering the kill strike to just kill without even because it's a drone, you still need the verification process and trying to detain and because when you have a civilian risk that happens, it's because the terrorist fights back and you fire back, and that gunfire can result in casualties. But a drone strike resulting in casualties is not because the terrorists fought back and there was this gunfire that caused collateral damage. The collateral damage simply because we struck first, and that is an ethical problem. That is a huge ethical problem, and there's no legal framework for it right now, and that's what they're trying to build to cover their ass. Obama administration is trying to cover their ass because in 3 years from now, it's going to be, 2016 election. What happens when a Republican administration takes over and they have this framework and they can do whatever the hell they want with drones? They're trying to cover their ass, and that's why Obama administration is working as fast as it can to create a legal framework, a constitutional framework for the use of drones. And that in itself is super problematic. So that's just my video on this. I don't know, for what it's worth, it was the speech I expected out of Obama. It's just the false dichotomy part was probably the most cringeworthy part. Him just going, the option of doing nothing is not an option. Of course that's not an option, but that's a false dichotomy. So, yeah, those are my thoughts. Cheers.